Hello my friends, my name is XFXHD, however, it's not relevant, at all. What really counts is what I'm going to show you today in this video, so let's jump right into the program, Adobe After Effects CS6, create a new composition and import these two pictures from the description. Now, pre-compose both of these pictures. I would suggest to name them Light A and Light B. Open the composition, duplicate the image and change the blending mode to Add. You should also move one of these to fill the space a bit more. Now go to the second composition, which is named Light B, and do practically the same thing again. You can also rotate one of these lights with the rotation tool. Now use the effect Turbulent Displays. When you solo the image with the effect, you can see that it's distorted, of course. Let's hold the key Alt and click on the stopwatch. Now type in time times 170 or another value as you like it. Now it's going to distort the image constantly by the value of 170 degrees. Copy the following effect with the Ctrl plus C and then paste it on the other two images with Ctrl plus V. Highlight both of these compositions and change the blending modes to Add. Then find the polar coordinates effect and add it to one of these compositions. Change the type to rect to polar and increase the interpolation to 100%. Now another step is to find the very popular effect called CC lens, put it on one of these compositions and play with the options, of course. You can influence the orb by changing the center and the size of it. You shouldn't touch the convergence value in this case. It's more practical to use it just when you have a squared footage. In this case, it's just an orb. By pressing T you can change the opacity, it can improve the final product. This step is optional. You can add color with the curves effect, however, I would recommend to use the free plugin from Video Copilot called VC Color Vibrance, which is working great with black and white footage. To improve the look, you can still change these lights from previous compositions. In this case, the blending mode screen is much better to use. Now create a new solid. Call it Particles and add the plugin called Particle World. You can turn off the grid if you want. In this step, go to Particles and change the particle type to Faded Sphere. Then lower the size of the particles it's going to have before dying out. Then go to the physics. Change the gravity to 0 and the animation to viscous. And again, add the CC lens effect and adjust it to your orb. Now change the blending mode to Add or to Screen and try to change the color of your particles to a fitting one, of course. You can add glow if it's improving the final look, however, try to keep distance to certain effects. At the end, you can also duplicate some of these compositions to fill the blank space. That's the final look. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.